Right. Well, I guess I'm going to talk today about coordination, vegan coordination. I know I'm along this track, but as the way it goes, somebody was talking today about the law of karma, and I'm like, oh my gosh, the law of karma. Eeks! You know, it brings out all these negations, you know, all the meat you've eaten before in the past, and all the murders that were your cause. You caused the murders of those animals, you know. All of that, you know, just swelling around, you know, your entire life through. It's like, oh my God, I ate that little piglet, and I ate that, you know, cow back then. You know, they're still there. You know, it's difficult to remove those. They're still there. I believe they dissipate, but they're negations. You know, they're still bringing harshness to you. They're bad. Experiences that you've given to others, you know, that's what this law of karma is all about. The bad experiences that you passed on, back to do unto others as they do unto you, that type of thing, well, yeah, it comes right back. It comes right back. And so there's that big negation. So, you know, you try to step a foot forward, and then you find out it's like, oh my gosh, you know, I was an evil. I was a murderess. I was the killer of those animals to eat them, whether they were at the store or whether they were at a restaurant. I was the accomplice in their death. You know, so I could eat when it was completely unnecessary. Completely unnecessary. All we ever needed to do was to open up our eyes as young children. And in this life, we get their mother's milk, and then we go on from there, and we have so many choices. Even way back then in the 1960s, it was very, 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 very easy to do, but it didn't happen in my family. So later on in life, I became vegan, later on. But still, there's all of that, you know, they're there, you know, all of those harms. The harms and the suffrages that I've created. It's a trail. It's a trail. It's like you wear those big wedding dresses. The harms and the suffrages are that big trail that you wear behind you. It's invisible, but it's there. And I think it just returns and comes back and bites you sometimes. And hopefully, eventually, it goes away and doesn't go into the next life. And that's what I'm hoping for, is that I don't carry this into the next life. I don't want to carry it at all into the next. I'd like to get free of it in this life. But as it's dissipating, I'm sitting here thinking about the vegan coordination. And we need jobs. We need a vegan network. We need this type of a formation. I just now looked up at this site called Indeed in the head, and I looked up vegan, and it brought up like pizza jobs or something. I mean, it was like, how pathetic. No, vegans want to work with vegan people in any job, in any type of career. Whether you guys are computer programmers, or whether you're going to make the latest, greatest lipstick, they want to work together. So I foresee that we have got to do this. We have got to make more vegan coordination type of companies for all things. The ones who make the point shoes, you know, anything, vegans, everything, coordination, different with that. So really, that's all I had to say, because that last video I had was a really, really long one. It's just been on and on, but I think that's my clarification today. I don't know. I'm off to start art again, but I am not wanting to do art because it's almost like the more complicated art becomes, or I make the art, you know, on that canvas, the more complicated I make it. I just don't want complicated right now, you know. I just want to steer away from complication. I think this complication isn't helping. I just want a simplified art rather than a complicated art. Do you understand? And unfortunately, people are attracted to all of those extravagant nitty-gritties. And, yeah, I don't know. I was looking at some beautiful animals today. The golden, the lion, golden lion tamarind monkey. Wow. Oh my gosh. You know, maybe he's my distant relative, but he's gorgeous. She is gorgeous. I'm just enthralled. They're in the Amazon. They have many of the tamarinds in the Amazon. They have the howlers there. Very beautiful. And they do have that one that has a really big nose, and I'm sorry, but he's not attractive, and he maybe he's attractive to the others in his group. And I feel sorry I said that, but I feel he's at a disadvantage, and I feel like maybe even the other monkeys there in the Amazon make fun of him or her because of the big nose. But anyway, something to think about. It's terrible, isn't it? Because they're so closely related looking, you know, the monkeys. I'd be like, but you're definitely, you're Vogue, you're the magazine, and you're not, pal. You know, I mean, all of that is already like, it's already shaped and formed in a way, you know what I'm saying? Before it became human brain, like we thought it in our brain, you know. You can already see the animals and like, no, no, no. We are the Vogue monkeys, and we are not.